beautiful Melissa Butler at your launch collaboration. This is your first collaboration, brand collaboration, and you partnered with Justine Skye. Tell me how you're feeling about tonight.
Well, I'm super excited. Honestly, this is our first collaboration. This is our first time really playing with color on the face. And like we launched a cheek and eye palette that's like super pretty. And so it can be used as eyeshadow, blush, highlighter. And so traditionally, we don't have any eyeshadow. So to have something that you can use like multi-purpose, but also like bringing color to the face, I think it just speaks to like the vibrancy and the fun and just bringing that back to makeup. Because I think makeup has gotten really complicated and really stuffy.
Yes.
With people thinking they needed to do like one thing or spend so much time or money. Mm-hmm. So with the launch of our Fast Face System, which is like 6 products, 7 minutes, you get your whole look. Mm-hmm. And then this collaboration with Justine Skye, I feel like we're really like really serving our customers in a dynamic way, in a fun way, in an affordable way, in a healthy way.
And for brown skin girls, can we just talk about that? Love the signage, love the messaging and the packaging and the branding that you guys put out with Island Gal. Tell us, how did you go about selecting Justine as your first collaborator for the brand?
Yeah, so the Lip Bar has always just been about authenticity and like really reminding our customers that they are enough and that they are worthy and that they need to be seen within the beauty space. And so when we thought about like, okay, number one, who can we collaborate with? Who do we want to collaborate with? We were like, well, we want to bring somebody to the table that our customers are going to believe in. And so that was going to have to be someone who also embodied that authenticity and embodied that playfulness and just that strength and power of being a Black woman. And I feel like that is exactly who Justine is. Like, she's talked about everything from her personal experiences to just being a Black woman to like being an independent artist. And so I just felt like she had the right spirit. She's incredibly talented, and obviously, like, she's super gorgeous,
right.
And like, you know, her,
like you.
Her melanin is popping,
right.
And so like the colors really bounce off of her complexion beautifully. We have 2 new lips in the collection,
mm-hmm.
And so like they're the perfect, like, nudes, like anyone can wear them,
right.
But they're perfect for brown girls, you
yes.
know what I'm saying?
And are you wearing it tonight?
Yeah, so I'm wearing her entire collection except the eyeliner. So I have on the cheek and eye palette as my blush, highlighter, and eyeshadow,
mm-hmm.
And then I'm wearing both nude lips.
Love. So let's get a little bit into the journey of Lip Bar. You're a fellow HBCU grad, FAMU, and you're Sarah.
Yes.
Delta, happy belated Founders Day. Speak to how FAMU helped shape you in your entrepreneurial journey thus far.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, FAMU taught me how to hustle, and it taught me how to sell myself. I think Detroit also taught me how to hustle, and then FAMU like affirmed it. But more than anything, FAMU taught me how to sell myself. It taught me that I had value. It taught me that, you know, I don't have to go into the room and try to figure out if I belong. It's like, no, you need to own the room, sort of thing. And so I appreciate that university so much. Like, and being a Delta taught me work ethic. It's like, no, sisterhood and work ethic. You're going to work hard and you're going to feel good about it. And you're going to be proud about this hard work. So I think FAMU changed my life. I always say that.
Yes. Speaking of your journey, you were on Shark Tank. You launched Lip Bar in 2012, and then you were on Shark Tank in, I believe, 2015.
Yes.
You got a lot of pushback. I watched the episode.
Yes.
And I mean, I was sitting there rooting for this brown skinned girl on screen with her products, because we hadn't really seen that on Shark Tank at that point.
Yeah.
Tell us how that rejection helped fuel you, because you're now in over 140 stores, Target stores. You're selling out worldwide. I mean, you're a known brand, African-American brand, female-led. Tell us how that rejection from Shark Tank pushed you.
Yeah, so we're actually in 500 Target stores.
Come on, 500.
So yeah, we're in 500 Target stores across the country. I mean, going on the show, it was a blip in the radar. It was just another thing that happened. And I've always been very comfortable with this idea of failure, because you get to learn from it. You get to grow from it. And so like, my entire journey with the Lip Bar has been about optimizing. It's like you do something, you test, you learn, you fail, you optimize. And so going on to that show was just another optimization of the brand. It's like more than anything, it taught me how to, like, which audiences to speak to and how to speak to those audiences. Because even though they weren't understanding of the company, which was totally fine, I needed to understand, like, where I went wrong in my pitch to them. So if you look at life as an entrepreneur, in a way where it's like every single thing that you do is a learning lesson. Like, even this collaboration will be a learning lesson. I will learn so many things. I've already learned so many things from it. Like, you will always grow and you'll always, like, have success within reach, because it's like you get to carve out your own path.
There's so many up-and-coming beauty brands that are out there now, especially African-American beauty brands. They see people like you, Rihanna, and they say, well, I can make this happen for myself. What advice would you give those people that want to start a beauty brand, or even just entrepreneurs in general, on sticking to the dream and carving a path for themselves?
Yeah, I mean, the Lip Bar is 7 years old now. I would say we didn't become a real company until we were 4.5 years old, until 5 years old, something like that. So, number one, you have to be super resilient and you have to know your why. You need to know why you're doing what the fuck you say you want to do every day, because it's going to get hard. It's not just taking pictures and videos and showing up. Like, being a CEO is difficult. Being a leader is even more difficult. And so making those tough decisions and really understanding when to pivot, why to pivot, what products you produce, all of that is going to be determined by your ability to stay strong within your why. And so you have to, number one, know exactly why you're starting it, and make sure it's a good reason. Just saying, like, oh, I want to start a company because I like lipstick, that's not good enough. Because, like, so what? Honestly. And then I think more than anything, you have to solve a problem. Like, you have no company if you're not solving a problem. You have no ability to gain market share unless there are other people who feel the exact same way about you and your who are other people who feel the same way about whatever problem it is and recognize that you are providing the solution.
Right. Will we get more brand collaborations from you? This is such a big deal, such a lot of hype behind it. People are, like, buying. I've been watching the Instagram. Everybody's, like, getting their products. Will you partner with other women in the future for Lip Bar?
Yeah, I'm sure. I mean, thus far, it's been a super positive experience. Justine Skye is such a beautiful spirit. And just, like, I think she's amazing. And I think that she was just such a great brand partner. And even today, she's just like, oh my God. And, you know, she's like being particular about the palette. She's like, I want more of the palette color to show up on my eyes, you know? So I think that it's a great opportunity. I think it's a good way to continue to grow your brand awareness, which is important, and to get in front of new audiences. So I see another one in the future.
Well, we love talking to you. Again, congratulations, Melissa. I'm a huge fan of you and I'm a huge fan of your brand. So I look forward to more brand collaborations and just whatever you do next.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank
you
so much.
Yes.
Where is the buzz? You said it was mine.